Everyone, welcome back to the channel. Today we're going to delve into managing your expectations, what you can expect when it comes to lucid dreaming. If you're new here, my name is Giz Edwards. I am a lucid dreaming coach and an entrepreneur based here in the UK. And on this channel, we delve into subjects such as lucid dreaming and entrepreneurship to make your lives more enjoyable, fulfilling, and more relaxed. And with that out of the way, let's crack on with this video. This is the sixth video in our lucid dreaming playlist, and today we're going to be talking about expectation management when it comes to lucid dreaming. The next few videos in this series are about expectation setting and other concepts surrounding that kind of general question, really. However, before you watch those videos, it is important to understand why it's necessary to manage expectations, especially when it comes to lucid dreaming, but this applies to basically all skill building in general. Many years ago, when I was doing my undergraduate degree at university, I had a friend who wanted to play the guitar. And he asked me for some advice because I had been playing for about 5 or 6 years up until this point. I said, sure, I'll help you. I'll teach you how to play guitar. And I asked him what it is that he wanted to learn, why he wanted to learn the guitar. And he said that he wanted to be able to play Ed Sheeran's A-Team to his girlfriend. And at the time, Ed Sheeran's A-Team, his first album, had only just released. So it was kind of like a big song. And I was like, sure, I can teach you that. But before I teach you that, I need to teach you the basics, because it's good to understand the foundations before you start building the walls. So I made him learn 4 chords, A, D, E, and E minor. And if you're a person who plays guitar, you might recognize those as some of the first chords you learn how to play. And you can play loads of songs with those. A week later, he came back to me and I asked him how he was getting on with playing the guitar. And he said to me, yeah, I'm doing pretty well. So then he played the 4 chords to me, and spoiler alert, he wasn't playing very well. He was it wasn't bad. It just wasn't great. It was more like he had learned the shapes, but hadn't really learned how to press his fingers down. Anyway, besides the point, I said to him, well, maybe take another week or two to learn how to do those chords properly before I teach you the next step, because he wasn't sounding particularly good. And the next chords that he would have learned are essentially all the chords you'd need for A-Team by Ed Sheeran, like G and C. So it was at that point where he said, do you know what? I'm not going to bother. And that day he quit playing the guitar a whole week after starting to learn. If he'd have carried on playing for maybe 2 weeks, he'd have been able to play A-Team amongst a load of other songs as well. And if he would have carried on to this day, which would be about 11 years ago, my God, how time flies, he would have been very good at guitar. A-Team wouldn't have even been a problem for him. He would have been so good at guitar that he would have been able to learn a lot more, let's put it that way. The reason he stopped is because his expectations were so much higher than he had envisioned. They were so much higher than what was achievable. I've spoken to a lot of people when it comes to lucid dreaming, from beginners to intermediaries to experts in the lucid dreaming field. And a lot of the beginners and intermediates had exactly the same expectations. They expect things like, I want one lucid dream per night every single night, straight off the bat. Whereas that's achievable in the long term, in the short term, in the medium term, no. It's very low down. People will quit if they don't achieve what they anticipated they would. It's just natural human behavior when it comes to skill building. It takes time to learn skills. And I have a personal belief that if you do small, tiny steps towards something bigger, it's a lot better. My cat is trying to open my door right now. Sorry, Slink, you're not coming in. I have a saying that a lot of small steps is better than one giant leap, and the journey of 1,000 miles starts with but a single step. So my point being is that chances are this lucid dreaming thing is going to take a lot longer than you expect. But not only that, the process of learning to lucid dream ties in with so many other different factors such as diet, exercise, mental state, social interactions, how much sleep you get. And we all know how flip-floppity one's mental state can be. The ultimate point that I'm trying to put forward is don't expect too much. Don't try and just smash lucid dreaming in lockdown and just nail it. Think of lucid dreaming as a marathon rather than a sprint, and you'll set your mind into a better, more healthier perspective of lucid dreaming. So over the next few weeks, I will be talking about different concepts of managing expectations and lucid dreaming and how they will be impacted by your thoughts. For example, I've got here how long it will take to have your first lucid dream, how many lucid dreams can you experience, how long is a lucid dream, and other topics like that. So if you fancy sticking around for that, then subscribe. My cat has opened the door. Where are you? I know you're here somewhere. So if you fancy sticking around for that, subscribe. And if not, then there's a link to the playlist below for the videos. If they haven't come out yet, you've got to wait. Until then, I'll see you all on Monday. Bye.